Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Josephine Eyang, a content creator based in Douala, Cameroon. If you're an old subscriber, thank you so much for clicking back. I feel so blessed being on your screens this wonderful day. And this is Fix It with Josie. I make educative content on parenting, relationship, marriage, counseling, lifestyle, vlogs, and more. In today's content, I want us to look at how reward systems can help motivate positive behavior in children. If you find that interesting, please hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up as we go straight into our topic for today. Reward system is a motivation mechanism that stimulates people to behave in a particular way and achieve desired results. They are widely used to motivate people and increase repeated behavior. This is common with companies where we hear of commissions, tips, and all that. We can also see this with business people when they talk about sales and discounts. So each time people hear that they will be motivated or they receive discounts for this or for that, it motivates them to keep repeating that same behavior. So business people have their customers coming back for more because they want to benefit from that discount or from the sales. Reward systems are a great tool to motivate or to shape behavior in children. So it is very important for us to know that if reward systems are not used appropriately, they might end up producing the wrong result desired. As parents, we can explore reward system in parenting and reinforce positive behavior in our children. Reward system, like I said, is a bit complicated when being used to kids. So if reward systems are not appropriately done, they might end up being misused or they might end up not producing the expected result. What do I mean? When kids feel that, when we make our kids to understand or feel that they get rewarded or paid for doing this or that, they may just stop doing that particular thing when they pay or the rewards stop coming. So as parents, it is our duty to ensure that these children understand the importance of values. Let them understand that their little actions of today help to molding them into the person they would like to become in future. Positive reward systems may not necessarily be rewarding them with physical cash or with material things. If parents turn to reward children each time they do anything good, it will turn to suppress their natural intrinsic motivation and passion to do that particular thing, because their attention will be shifted. It will be now focused on the reward and not their passion or the interest they have in doing that particular thing. So rewards must not be consistent. So I think the best way parents can use rewards to improve positive behavior in children is by showing them genuine appreciation. Everyone loves to be appreciated, even children. I take example from my little boy in the house here. He's just 1 year, 9 months, getting to 2 years. And each time he's from bedding, when he comes back, I say, Papa, you are looking good. Look at your shoe. See how handsome you look. He changes his walk. He feels himself. He just wants to know that I appreciate how he looks and the fact that he just had his bath. And if I try to ignore him or if I try to act like I did not see, he will keep calling my attention to it. Mommy, look. Mommy, see. Mommy, look. Mommy, see. It's just to show us that even children want to be appreciated. Even children love to receive that appreciation from their parents. So we can use appreciation to reinforce positive behavior in our children. It works a great deal. Secondly, encouragement and celebration are a great way parents can use to reward their children. to reinforce that positive behavior, to ensure that they keep doing that particular thing. Yeah, when you see your child struggling with something, for example, I have my 7 years old son in the house here. When I teach him something and I say, okay, we just did this, try to do it on your own, I see him struggling. At first, I used to shout, we just did this, why are you still not able to do it and things like that? But I noticed that when I start shouting, it creates that tension in him. He now becomes frightened. He will not, even if it's something that he can do, he will become scared. But now when I start encouraging him, you can do it, you are very intelligent. Remember that you did this thing yesterday now. It's the same thing, just try to do it. It will boost him up. You will see that he can even try to do it. And finally, he will do it. So when he does it, I clap for him, I hug him, I carry him up, just to let him know that he did something very good. So rewards are very, so appreciation and celebration are a great way parents can also use in reinforcing positive behaviors in children. Lastly, setting goals together with your children is an effective method in order to achieve that positive behavior modification. How can you do this? You do this by having a genuine conversation with your children in a more relaxed atmosphere where they feel so comfortable and involved in the communication. Let them have a say. Let them feel that they contributed. When they feel heard, when they feel involved in the communication, it will ensure effective result. Yeah. I will still bring you people an example of my son. Yes, I like to use examples. I'll bring an example of my son. Like, I noticed that during prayer times, because we always pray at 8 p.m. in the evening before we go to bed. So I noticed that during prayer hours, he always falls asleep. And it is because when he comes back from school, after eating, he doesn't go to nap. He just plays around and he gets tired. So you see that during prayer time, he always sleeps. So I called him and I said, you see that you are always sleeping during prayers and it's not good. So I had a conversation with him. I told him, this is what we are going to do. You will come back from school after eating, you sleep for 30 minutes and I'll wake you up to go and play so that you just get to rest a bit. That way you will not be sleeping during prayers. And so that is what we started doing. So the first day after prayers, he did not sleep and he was so excited. After prayers, he came and said, Mommy, you see, I did not sleep today. And I said, that was very good. Come and take high five. And he was happy that I appreciated, I recognized that. And because we had a conversation about it and he felt involved, and that is why it was easier for us to achieve that result. So each time children feel involved, they feel heard, it is always easier to achieve that result. And again, one thing I want to make us parents to know is that these goals, when we are setting goals for kids, they must be age-related, stage-appropriate. That is what I should say. They should be stage and age-appropriate for them. And of course, it may not work immediately. It's going to take some time. We just have to be realistic. We just have to set realistic goals. And if it doesn't work, we are learning, we are trying, we are flexible to changing to some other thing that will work. So guys, please, if you have watched right up to this point, why not subscribe? Please don't watch and leave without subscribing. Subscribe, like the video, support your girl. We are moving forward. Be part of this journey with us. Thank you. See you in my next one. Bye-bye.